All stories begin with once upon a time. The story that I really want to tell you also begins like this, but there is a small difference. And the difference is, once upon this time. There lives you.
Hello, everyone. I hope you're all well, healthy, safe. And another opportunity for this one-to-one broadcast. Really, the story that I want to tell is a story of us, you, me, being alive on the face of this earth. I know there's a lot of judgments that come into it. You know, how's this? How's that? Am I well? Am I not well? Are things going my way? Are things not going my way? I mean, every single day, we are bombarded by these ideas. And it's very important to us that things go our way, whatever that happens to be. But give this a thought. There is something on a very fundamental level that is taking place. And that happens to be you're alive. To a lot of people, they don't know what to make of that. You're alive, and then that means you can do this, and you can do this, and are you doing this, and are you not doing this, and have you done those cool things that are the cool things to do? Whatever they happen to be. I have seen things change in my life. I have seen those things that were once considered really cool, abandoned. Nobody cares about them anymore. People have moved on. I remember when I first came, the way the cars looked, they don't look like that anymore. And I suppose they wouldn't even try to make one look like that because I don't think it would sell too well. The way the houses are made, the way everything is, it changes and it changes, the fashion, the suits, haircuts. Everything changes. But for some reason, we don't look at these changes and reflect upon them. What does that mean when that change happens? What does that mean that that's not the cool thing anymore? That this is the cool thing now. Well, what it's telling you is that all those things that change, they change because they are changeable. They can change. And I know that's very obvious, but let me come to the point. But there is something that doesn't change. And that's here too. So when you see all these changes, one of the things that it needs to inspire in you is that very question, is there something that doesn't change? Is there something that stays the same? I mean, when you look at what can change, there's so many things that change. Families change. You know, maybe there's a father, there is a mother, they have a child, that child grows up, he has children, now the original mother and father are grandparents. And then, of course, you know, maybe there is the family structure, there's the grandfather, there's the grandmother, there's the father, there's the mother, and then there's the children. And then Maybe the grandfather leaves and the whole structure of the family starts to change. Then maybe the grandmother leaves and then that structure starts to change again. Then the father becomes grandfather and that structure starts to change. Everything changes. Houses change, people come in, they don't like the way the house looks, they get it painted, they change this, they change that, they update it. These are all things that change. And we try so hard, so incredibly hard, because we don't want to change. We don't want to change. We don't want to look old. We want to look young. We want good things to stay that way. But in this whole process of discovering, did you ever ask the question, is there something that doesn't change? Is there something that is so good, so evolved, that it doesn't need to evolve anymore? So good, so perfect, that it doesn't need to change. It works. And that your existence, that power that allows for this existence to take place, that energy, that reality, it doesn't change. But was keeping people alive in the 1200s, was keeping them alive in the 1300s, 1400s, 1500s, 16, 17, 18, 1900s. And here we are. 2000, 2020, same thing is keeping us alive. We exist. And then there are the quests that are so fundamental, so incredibly fundamental. Thirsts embedded inside of each human being that is so incredibly fundamental that they don't change either. Year after year, generation after generation, century after century, decade after decade, indeed, day after day, hour after hour, minute after minute, indeed, second after second, there is a thirst, a want that also doesn't change. And it is a want to be fulfilled. A cup that remains empty, and when you fill it, it gets bigger. Fill it more. Fill it more. And more is relative, because what is your capacity? What is your capacity to know? What is your capacity to be fulfilled? What is your capacity to face reality? What is your capacity to be in the joy? Well, no limits, infinite. That's what we're talking about here. This is that story. And does it get fulfilled? Is it complex? Yes, it's incredibly complex. Why is it complex? It's because we have wandered so far off that center line. We've gone so far in the search to be happy. To be happy, we have gone and we have decimated this planet so that we could be happy. We have made the lives of all the animals on the face of this earth miserable. Elephants, alligators, sharks, fish, whales, lions, tigers, birds. So we could be happy. This is how strong that desire to be happy is. Oh, believe me, when people say, oh yeah, you know, you need to have a good job and you need to have a good home and you need to have a good family and you need to have a good this and a good that and then you can be happy. I say, come on, take a look around. Would you really go to that extent to have a good house and to have a good family and a good this and a good that? Because to have a good family takes you, not the decimation of this planet Earth. All it takes is you sharing your love, caring. To have a beautiful home, a home is not defined by its beauty that is on the outside. It is defined by the beauty of those people who live in it. Job security is not defined by your job, but it is defined by how secure you feel being alive every single day. Having money, it is not how much money you have, is what you do with it. These are the definitions for people of happiness. Oh no, this, listen, it may not seem like it, but there is something else going on. There is definitely something else going on. For human beings to be at the stage where they are perfectly, they have got their explanation, they have perfectly defined instant death to anybody that infringes upon their circle. Oh, so much so, it is preemptive, it might happen. That is a mark of a coward. That's the mark of a coward, somebody who's not prepared, who doesn't understand. In the name of God, in the name of religion, we're ready to destroy each other and have been destroying each other for a really long time. Something else going on in this story that does not seem obvious, but it's going on. And this story better start turning towards those realities that truly affect the human condition. To find that contentment not outside, but inside. To find that reality not on the outside, but to find it inside. To find that peace on the inside. To find that joy on the inside. To find that beauty on the inside. Where it is, where it has existed, not as a fashion trend, but has existed for thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and indeed millions of years. To where those many, 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 many before us have said what you are looking for is inside of you. They left us the mark. You're going to need this. They could see. They could see what was afoot, the changes. That these changes were no small changes. These were thirsts for power, of which a human being could not ever have enough. And in their wisdom, they saw that we would be ready to destroy anything that we felt was coming in our way of our happiness, of our joy. And out of that incredible kindness, what did they say? They left us the biggest clue so that this story goes well, that your story goes well. And what they said is what you're looking for is inside of you. That's where you'll find it, not outside. Of course. Where have we looked for it? Always on the outside. 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 That's where the attention goes. Always on the outside. Always on the outside. Where is the happiness? On the outside. You feel lonely. What do you need? Not to find the friend on the inside. No. Give your friend a call. Let's meet there. Let's do this. Let's do that. Instead of sitting down with yourself and spending a little time and contemplating and meditating, looking around, telling yourself, understanding how fortunate you are that you are alive. Do you take that time? Do you take that time to contemplate on just the fact that you're alive? Not immediately jump to, what does it mean I'm alive? What do I do? You're not a doing machine, you're a feeling machine. Yes, you can do, but you can also feel. And you can feel like you wouldn't believe how much you can feel. You have intricate emotions. Oh, you can, of course, you can smell. Ah, amazing. And perfumes people have created, amazing. You can see colors, paintings that people have created, amazing. So yes, you are a do machine, but you are a feeling machine too. That so many of those beautiful feelings are expressed in that painting. Yes, that was a do, but first there was a feel. And what do you feel? What can you feel? So for all the things in this world that one can feel, you can also feel that divine that is inside of you. What you're looking for, you will find inside of you. You are not abandoned. You're never alone. Wherever you go, that divine goes with you. Wherever you go, wherever you are, no matter how bad the situation is, no matter how dark it gets, There is a light inside of you. No matter how bad it may be, how hopeless it may be, there is a hope that is inside of you. For you. Not for somebody else, but for you to experience. For you to understand. To make sense of it. To put things in perspective. You know, we have two eyes. And what is the purpose of having the two eyes? In these eyes, using both these eyes, we can judge distance. One slightly out of focus, then the other one, and we can see, when we see something, we can see how far it is. If you don't have that, you may not be able to judge the distance properly. You have 2 ears. And what do they give you? They give you direction from where the sound is coming from. So, what if we were to take that and understand that we also have been given this ability to feel? Not something particular, but feel something that is incredibly beautiful. That there is a yearning inside of us to feel that beauty. There's a yearning inside of us to feel that joy. Feel. Turn within and feel. Feel that goodness that is inside of you. Feel that hope that is inside of you. And when you are filled with that, those then are your true riches. Then you are rich. Not the money that changes. Today it's yours, tomorrow it'll be somebody else's. Your house, today it's yours, tomorrow it'll be somebody else's. Your car, today it's yours, tomorrow it'll be somebody else's. All of these things. You live in your apartment? Well, there's other people who have lived in your apartment before you. And after you, somebody else will live in that apartment. But here, in your heart, there is something that is just for you. In this time, in this moment, just for you. Fulfill this story. That's the only story that remains unfulfilled. Fulfill this story. And if you do, your life will never be boring. The wisdom of the ages will be yours to enjoy. Well, that's what I wanted to say. So, stay well, stay healthy, and enjoy the one-to-ones. If you do, please subscribe and feel free to write to me any expressions, any questions that you have. I do read them. And when I get an opportunity, I will put those out, the answers to them. Oh, yes. And I am working on a peace education program that will be coming. I'm glad I didn't do it when I was going to do it. I think we should have a little patience. I said to myself anyways. Because, lockdowns are coming more and more and more. So maybe a more appropriate time is coming and is here to do those peace education programs. But until then, whatever I can say to you that can help you and enjoy this life, fulfill your story, I will try. Thank you very much.